Julian from Julian Tech TM, and today is a very special video because this PC will be my personal PC. It's gonna be a chapalang build because I'm not quite sure which component I'm gonna use, but I know which CPU and motherboard I'll be using. I'll be using the AMD 7900X. Yes, why not the 7950X? Because that one too expensive. And this will be already an upgrade to my home PC, which is the 5950X, and also my office PC, which is the 12900K. The motherboard I'm going for is the ROG Crosshair X670E Hero by ASUS ROG. The RAM I'm using is the G-Scale RGB DDR5. I have 4x16GB. I'm gonna fill up all. Anyway, the speed is 5600 mega transfers per second and it's a CL36. Now, the other thing that I'm not quite sure what to use is which GPU. We have the 4080 and the 7900 XT and XTX. That one I'm not quite sure which one I'm gonna use. Why? Because the case I'm gonna use is the Fractal North. Yes, the wooden PC. I got it in white with a hint. It means can see through a bit. Why haven't I chosen the GPU? Because I don't even know whether the 4080 would fit the case. And I'm gonna dismantle this PC in a month's time. Why? Because one, this 4080 with this configuration is supposed to be water cool. I've been like delaying this for a year. And why am I not waiting? Because I need a PC at home. If not, this hardware is sitting doing nothing. Other than that, the CPU cooler I'll be using is the Be Quiet Pure Loop 360 AIO cooler. I have Be Quiet fans also because good cooling. Next is my hard drive. This is basically my old hard drive. In a way, this video, I'm upgrading my PC. And the components that I'll be reusing is my NVMe SSDs. My hard drive. For the PSU, I'm using the FSP 1200 watt power supply. If you watch my table PC, that is the table PC that I'm upgrading. Reason for me changing is because, yeah, the table PC was great, but I realized I got space. With that, let's build the PC. The reason why I'm not doing the custom water loop now is because I ordered the water block for my 4080 and it will not arrive until 16 January. Yeah, I had to pay for the custom water loop. This build is so expensive. ASUS ROG. So we have the beautiful motherboard. Oh! It comes with a PCIe 5.0 M.2 card. Put this one side, let's see what else in the box. Card, ooh, more stickers. More for my guitar. Manual, which I don't need. Bunch of cables. So triangle to triangle, triangle is on the, ooh, stop left, right. It's recommended to actually get quad channel instead of dual channel. Even getting two dual channels is not recommended. There might be some problems getting two dual channels, but it's rare. If you're thinking of getting quad channel, just get quad channel. But it's okay. I like to live life dangerously. Looks good. NVMe SSD. So we will have two slots that I need to fill up. The NVMe SSD I have is the Clef C920, which is Gen 4, 2TB, and Crest C720, which is 1TB. So for the Gen 4, I'm gonna put at PCIe 5. The other one, I'm gonna put in the not so fast one lah. Huh?
There we go.
Haha. So we have two thermal pads, one here and one here. Plus NVMe SSD. That's a huge ass heat sink for the NVMe SSD, man. Okay, next one is, there we go. So we have two NVMe here. So technically I can put a CPU cooler now, but I feel like I need to see how the case is first before I do anything. So as I said, Fractal North, the wooden PC basically. There we go. Look at this case. Clean. There's like leather here. You can see at the back, there's a leather like strip here. This is class. Look at the buttons, USB. Because I have a 360 radiator, it has to be at the front. So I have to figure out how to install the radiator at the front. Slide, I guess. Yep, slide it out. Wow, look at that. Even the metal. Yeah, it's not completely black. It's this gray color. I'm pretty sure. Just take the front out. Ah, yes. Look at that. First thing we do is take out the fans. I just want to prep everything before I put the motherboard in, you know? Usually the thing that wastes the most time is getting to know the case. Because sometimes if you don't know the case, you have to redo a lot of things. Double work. Work smart and hard. There we go. So I need to remove the fans. Yeah. There we go. Got the hard drive bay. So by right, you can put two hard drive, but because my PSU is huge, as you can see, the hard drive bay is in the way. So there's supposed to be two hard drive. I can just put this hard drive to the left. Move this. Okay, usually I'll put the CPU cooler, right? But I feel like this...
I need to add the motherboard first.
I'm not sure, but you know what? I'm gonna add the CPU cable in first. Okay, I don't want to add the motherboard in first, because you see, like, where should I put the radiator? Where should I put the fans? Because if I put the fans, I should put it now. And I should be taking out the top. Slide! Ah, there we go. I definitely can't put the radiator on top. I'll just put the fans here. Pum, pum. Fan, fan, fan. Radiator, fan. So I have the Be Quiet Silent Wing 3. Oh my god. Oh, some put attachment one leh. I can put this attachment that use the regular screws, or this attachment that uses their own mounting way. You know what? I'll try their interesting mounting way.
Oh, that doesn't sound. Oh, that's not good.
Oh crap! I broke it. I broke one, so I'm gonna just use the regular one first. I'm thinking the top two I mount it regularly, then the bottom two I'll mount it the interesting way that they have. Okay. There you go, regular. Air intake here, air out there. So air blow outside like this. So I'm guessing all I have to do is just put it in. That's what she said. Interesting way of mounting it, but yeah. Looking good. Next thing to install is the CPU cooler. So why do I install a CPU cooler first? Because one thing I'm afraid is that it's gonna be very tough to add the motherboard in before I add the CPU cooler. Also, I can check which GPU we can fit in. Wow, they have coolant. That is great. So why is this great? It's because in a few years time, not say run out, but there will be less coolant, and being able to top up increase the lifespan.
Wow. I think I'm gonna buy Be Quiet AIOs from now. They can last like more than 5 years.
Ah, okay. So I have to add everything like here, I guess. Yeah, this fits. All right. And because I can't put it in the front, I foresee that I definitely cannot put the 4080. So because I have to install, you can see that the fan and everything is all protruded out in the case. So you know what, just for the fun of it, I haven't opened this yet, so I'm gonna open this. The RTX 4080 ROG Strix Gaming. This unboxing will definitely be very nice, but too bad, I don't think I can use it. Ba-ba. Oh, just, yeah, cannot one lah. Look at how huge this thing is. Holy crap, it's so heavy. Do I even need to take it out? No lah. Let's take it out just to see how good it looks. Look at how beautiful this is. Technically, you can see that this is the card actually. So if I water cool, it's gonna be very small. The thing is, I don't really want to use this case for water cooling, because firstly, I'm gonna use two 360 radiators. Stay tuned for that video, okay? Is AMD small enough though? I don't think so leh. Let's start with the XT. Very nice. Ken, I think Ken.
Yeah, look at the size. Wow.
Yes, I like. Thank you, AMD. Having a small GPU. I think the XTX is just a little bit thicker, but not wider or lengthier.
And this.
Oh!
Okay.
Let's see the size.
The size.
Oh, lengthwise is a little bit longer. Let me double check. Lengthwise and thickness wise is a little bit bigger. So let's see if we can fit this in. No problem. How about the XTX? No problem. Nice. We're gonna use the XTX. So just for funsies. What the hell? Look at the difference between the two. Oh my god. Funny thing is, weight wise, very similar. This is definitely a little bit more heavy, but for a small GPU, this is dense. So it's actually not too bad, because usually I like to use both Nvidia and AMD's GPUs. Usually in the office, I use Nvidia. At home, I use AMD's GPU, just to give a better conclusion, no matter what it is, in terms of software, in terms of like the GPU. I think now we can actually add in the motherboard. Here we go. Okay. And I'm gonna have to dismantle this in a month's time. Why do I do this to myself? For content. For content. And also, I need a PC.
Alrighty, tidy, lefty, loosey, not too tight. Just thread it in first.
Let's see how it looks. If it's like that, you can see the logo, but then the cable is a bit meh. It's like that. Cable is in the way, but it seems like a very good curl, right? Because it doesn't touch the GPU. And it's a good length. Let's see this one again. It's like, bleh. It's like, bleh. I can, even like that, it kind of blocks the logo. It's my first time doing it like this.
Only professionals can do this.
It works! Don't forget, remove plastic. Oh, look at that, shiny. Sweet la. Very nice. So here's the thing about motherboards nowadays, especially for the higher end motherboards, it comes with this pin. You see all the labeling on it? And instead of attaching the cables like this, you can attach it
on this itself.
First,
next one is the audio cable. So it's here. So next is the Type-C and USB 3.0. So for the PSU, we're gonna prep it by over here at the side. I'm gonna put in all the cabling first. So even though we need 2 8-pin PCIe power, and usually one cable will split off to two, a lot of GPU recommend that you have two separate cables. And because FSP PCIe power is like that, I'll do some cable management later. The thing is, I might be putting this PC on the floor, although like, you know, it's white and it's nice, I don't want to put it on the floor, but to save space, I might. And since this case, there's airflow here, so I can. So I'll put it fan up. Now I can add the CPU power into the PSU.
Oh, scare me. This motherboard has extra power. I think it's for...
Okay, so that extra 6-pin is called the PD 12-volt power. It's for additional power for your PCIe X16 slot. Means the top PCIe slot. To support 60 watts. That slot is for PCIe 5.0. So without that, you're basically using PCIe 4. It is a PCIe 5, but because PCIe 5 needs more power. And the 7900 series card will not use PCIe 5.0. So technically, I don't need. So in the future, they will improve the 12-pin power to like, I think 6-pin. It's very much like the NVIDIA 12-pin, the small one. But for now, this is the workaround for PCIe 5. I don't need PCIe 5 because my GPU is not PCIe 5. My NVMe SSD is not Gen 5.
What's left is the GPU and hard drive.
The way to do it is to add this here. Let me screw this in. Why is there the rubber piece, which is the dampener, so that it doesn't make any noise when it moves.
Ah, fits. Nice.
So here's a tip for cable managing. If you think you're done with a certain area, then you can cable manage. I know I want the cables to be here, then you cable manage. If you're not sure, don't cable manage.
There we go. So I'm gonna leave it that way first, because we're gonna add in the GPU.
So why I want to add the GPU before all the cable management? Because there is still this GPU cable here that I'm not sure how is it gonna be. Finally, the GPU. Add this super chill GPU. I don't know what's this, but let's use it. I mean, I know what is this, but I just, you know. Oh, knack. Because I am going to bring this home, so I want to have a good support for the GPU. Since it comes with the motherboard, right? Why not?
It looks all right.
So with this, you need to kind of cable manage. Okay, now everything is plugged in, SATA cable and all. I'm not going to do the cable management until I make sure that the PC works. Press the button and it runs. Woo, look at that. Make sure the fans are all running. Fan run, fan run, fan run. But yeah, this is not too bad. I think what I can do, I can peel this off. Let's do the peel. Oh, I realized I could have put the fans in front. But then again, I don't think the fans will fit.
Yeah, it won't.
Hey, it will. Eh. Shit, man, I should have done that. So you'll see the fan here. Yeah. Why me nothing? So, you know what? It's kind of working. I just need to troubleshoot what's wrong with it. I will do a time lapse and have a voiceover. So, future Julian, we'll talk to you now.
Julian from the future here. I just had to wait a little while for the PC to boot and it's all good. Then I did the cable management for the PC. Then I had to transport this PC back to my room. Then it's just setting up, testing the PC in my room. So I did a few benchmarks and here is what I have for you. In terms of GPU, it's very interesting. Looking at ray tracing benchmarks, the 7900 XTX has made great improvements, beating the RTX 3090. But the RTX 4080 also made big improvements, being still the best option for ray tracing. For time Spy using DX12 technology paints the same picture. 7900 XTX better than RTX 3090, but not the RTX 4080. But when we look at Firestrike, which uses DX11, the 7900 XTX is better than the RTX 4080, which is consistent with the last gen AMD GPU, having the 6900 XT being better than the RTX 3090. AMD has a reputation to be better at DX11. I've been using the 7900 XTX for gaming and editing this video, and so far, no problems. At the end of the day, it all comes down to price.
Okay, now the video is done. I actually changed up the format of the room. Now the bed, yeah, I know it's a bit messy. The bed is here and the PC is on this corner. It's because of feng shui, like legit feng shui. And look at this PC, it looks so good. I changed the RAM so that it doesn't light up so that I can sleep, because even if you turn off the PC, the RAM doesn't turn off. But everything else turns off when you turn off the PC. So it just looks so good, even with or without the lights. But yeah, what do you guys think? I know the cable is a little bit messy because I have to transfer the footage later on from this.
But yeah, looking good, huh?
As I mentioned, this will not be the end of this PC. This is just a temporary PC so that I can use a PC at home. I will be water cooling this PC with the 4080. I'm just waiting for my water block, which delayed to 20th January. Sad. But it will come soon enough. Spent a lot of money, so if you guys can subscribe, like the video, comment, it would mean a lot. Oh yeah, one more thing, there is a giveaway for this video. I forgot to thank Asus, which now I remember, so I didn't really forget. Asus actually helped me with the resources of the motherboard and the GPU, the 4080, and they gave merch for me to give away. So yeah, all you have to do is comment, like, subscribe, and go on to my Instagram, because that's the only way I can pick someone and message you guys if you want. I already gave away a keyboard, a mouse, and a bag from the last Aftershock video. So yeah, it's fun. You guys seem to really like the giveaway, so I'm gonna give more. There's also a hard drive giveaway that's out now already. As in out, like it's posted already, so be sure if you want to win a hard drive. So yeah, that's about it. If you have any questions, do comment in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe. Like freaking a lot of people of y'all not subscribe, y'all watch but never subscribe. Never mind, you subscribe, can't really. Other than that, hope you enjoyed this video again, and I'm done.